morning, everyone. This is Dr. Adel Bondak, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. Today I will talk about implantation of the blastocyst into the endometrium of the uterus. First, what is implantation? Implantation is embedding of the blastocyst into the endometrium, inside the endometrium of the uterus. I will talk about onset and the completion, process of implantation, and the sites of implantation. Onset, when does it begin and when does it end? It begins on day 6 after fertilization, and it is completed on day 11 after fertilization. So implantation begins on day 6 and is completed on day 11 after fertilization. Then the process of implantation. The process of embedding, you know that the blastocyst is surrounded by zona pellucida, so the first step must be degeneration of zona pellucida. So degeneration of zona pellucida on day 6. After degeneration of zona pellucida, the blastocyst is attached to the endometrium. So number 2, attachment of the blastocyst to the endometrium on day 6. After attachment of the blastocyst to the endometrium, the trophoblast differentiates into two layers, outer syncytial trophoblast and inner cytotrophoblast. This outer syncytial trophoblast, the dark green color layer, is the invading layer, is the active layer. It secretes proteolytic enzymes. These enzymes form a hole in the endometrium. The enzymes erode the endometrium and form a hole. Through this hole, the blastocyst is gradually embedded into the endometrium. On day 11, the blastocyst is completely embedded inside the endometrium, and the endometrium is now called decidua. Again, this is the blastocyst. It is surrounded by zona pellucida. So the first step is degeneration of zona pellucida on day 5. Second step, attachment of the blastocyst to the endometrium. And third step, the trophoblast differentiates or divides into two layers, outer syncytial trophoblast and the inner cytotrophoblast. The outer syncytial trophoblast secretes proteolytic enzymes. These enzymes erode the endometrium and form a hole. Through this hole, the blastocyst enters or embeds into the or invades the endometrium. Okay, so this is the blastocyst inside the endometrium. So the syncytial trophoblast secrete proteolytic enzymes which erode the endometrium. The blastocyst gradually invades the endometrium, and this hole in the endometrium is closed by blood clot and by proliferation of the epithelium. And now the endometrium is called decidua. So the decidua is the endometrium after implantation of the blastocyst. Now, sites of implantation, and this is a very important topic. Sites, we have normal site and the abnormal sites. The normal site, you have to remember 3 points. Number 1, in the upper part. Number 2, posterior roll of the body of the uterus, and number 3, in the midline. So the normal site of implantation is in the upper part of the posterior roll of the body of the uterus, in the midline. Then abnormal sites. Abnormal sites may be uterine or extrauterine. Uterine is called the placenta previa. So placenta previa is implantation of the blastocyst in the lower part of the uterus near the internal os of the cervical canal. Placenta previa. Outside the uterus is called ectopic pregnancy, and the commonest site is in the uterine tube. Tubal pregnancy and implantation on the surface of the ovary ovarian pregnancy and implantation on the surface of the abdominal organs like the intestine or the stomach. Again, sites of implantation, normal and abnormal. Normal, upper part of the posterior wall of the body of the uterus in the midline. Abnormal sites, uterine and extrauterine. Uterine in the lower part of the uterus near the internal os, and it's called the placenta previa. Outside the uterus is called ectopic pregnancy, tubal pregnancy, pregnancy in the uterine tube, ovarian pregnancy, pregnancy on the surface of the ovary, and abdominal pregnancy on the surface of the organs like the intestine or the stomach. Again, sites of implantation. This is the normal site. So the normal site here, upper part of the posterior wall of the body of the uterus in the midline. Abnormal sites, uterine and extrauterine. Uterine in the lower part of the uterus near the internal os, and is called the placenta previa. Extrauterine is called the ectopic pregnancy. So the ectopic sites are tubal pregnancy, pregnancy in the uterine tube, tubal pregnancy like this one, tubal pregnancy, tubal pregnancy, and ovarian pregnancy. This is ovarian pregnancy on the surface of the ovary, and abdominal pregnancy on the surface of the abdominal organs like the intestine or the stomach. So normal site and abnormal sites. Abnormal sites, uterine and extrauterine. Extrauterine are called, extrauterine sites are called ectopic sites. Now, placenta previa. What is placenta previa? First, this is the normal site of the placenta. And this is placenta previa. Implantation in the lower part of the uterus near the internal os. This is the internal os. So what is placenta previa? Placenta previa, implantation of the blastocyst in the lower part of the uterus near the internal os. What are the types of placenta previa? We have three types. These are the three types. Placenta previa lateralis, placenta previa marginalis, and the placenta previa centralis. The first one, placenta previa lateralis, this one. The placenta is in the lower part of the uterus, but doesn't reach the internal os. Placenta previa marginalis, the placenta is in the lower part of the uterus and partially covers the internal os. Partially covers the internal os. And the third type, placenta previa centralis, the placenta completely covers the internal os. It is very dangerous because premature separation of the placenta may lead to severe bleeding. Again, what is placenta previa and what are its types? Placenta previa is implantation in the lower part of the uterus near the internal os. How many types? Three types. Lateralis, marginalis, centralis. Placenta previa lateralis doesn't reach the internal os. Placenta previa marginalis partially covers the internal os. Placenta previa centralis completely covers the internal os. It is very dangerous because premature separation of placenta causes severe bleeding. So this is placenta previa, the first abnormal site. Now, ectopic pregnancy. What is ectopic pregnancy? Ectopic pregnancy is pregnancy outside the uterus. The commonest site of ectopic pregnancy is tubal pregnancy. Pregnancy in the uterine tube. Pregnancy in the uterine tube. What is the fate of this pregnancy? The fate of tubal pregnancy is tubal rupture and internal hemorrhage because the uterine tube will not accommodate the growing fetus. So this is the first one, tubal pregnancy, and the fate, inevitable rupture of the uterine tube. Second one, this is the tubal pregnancy. Second one, on the surface of the ovary, ovarian pregnancy. Ovarian pregnancy, implantation on the surface of the ovary. And the third one is implantation on the intestine, on the abdominal organ, abdominal pregnancy, abdominal pregnancy, implantation on the abdominal viscera like the intestine or the stomach. So what are the ectopic sites of pregnancy? The commonest one is tubal pregnancy, ovarian pregnancy, and then abdominal pregnancy. And finally, what is decidua? Decidua is the endometrium after implantation of the blastocyst. What are the types of decidua? We have three types of decidua. You have to know the location of each one and the fate of each one. Decidua basalis, this one, decidua capsularis, and decidua parietalis. Decidua basalis, between the blastocyst and the myometrium. Decidua capsularis, between the blastocyst and the uterine cavity. And decidua parietalis, it is the remaining part of the decidua. Look here, this is a uterine cavity. During pregnancy, this uterine cavity is obliterated by fusion of decidua capsularis and decidua parietalis. This is a uterine cavity, decidua capsularis, and decidua parietalis. What is the fate of each one? Of course, the most important one is decidua basalis because it forms the maternal part of the placenta. Decidua capsularis and decidua parietalis fuse with each other and degenerate. So, what is decidua? Decidua is the endometrium after implantation. How many types? Three types. Decidua basalis, capsularis, parietalis. Decidua basalis between the blastocyst and the myometrium, and this decidua basalis forms the maternal part of the placenta. Decidua capsularis between the blastocyst and the uterine cavity, decidua parietalis is the remaining part of the decidua, and during pregnancy, the uterine cavity is obliterated by fusion of decidua capsularis and decidua parietalis. And thank you very much. Best wishes and good luck. And see you in another video.